All right, Aki Kareem for BBTV. I'm delighted to be joined by a standout amateur fighter, turned professional, undefeated, 3-0, Lisa Whiteside. Firstly, Lisa, thanks for spending some time with us today. I hear you've had a busy day looking after kids and all sorts.
Yeah, just the daily routine of having a little boy now, but also, yeah, looking after my nephews because obviously it's school holidays and my sister's working. So, yeah, just all mucking together and look after everyone.
Now, I know obviously being a mother is a massive, massive part of your life, the number one part of your life. But, you know, I think I get the sense you're itching to get back in the ring now as well.
Yeah, it's obviously prior to little boy arriving, I'd obviously had three fights, fighting at flyweight, and but we was having issues to when it came to it, when we looked into things that I couldn't actually conceive because of making weight so much. And I think it's quite an issue for elite athletes to a certain level of obviously weight making, I think runners and things like that. So had to make that decision, and it wasn't a hard decision to make because me and my husband, you know, family always would come first over everything. So stepped away from the boxing, didn't know if I would want to come back or not. But then once I got through to about 20 weeks pregnant, knew everything was okay, I was already thinking, oh, I want to get back in there. I can't wait. I want to get back boxing. So I carried on obviously training throughout my pregnancy to the level that you can. And then, yeah, as soon as baby was here, I'm like, oh, I've got to go and get him a world title. So it's just, yeah. And I think just because in that time span of me being pregnant, how big it's gone with the, you know, how Eddie Earn has just made it massive for female boxing. I just feel like why, you know, it'd be stupid not to give it a go.
Yeah, he has made female boxing massive, to be fair. And, you know, I saw your tweet where you sort of, you said you've got a very keen eye on that. There's two female world title fights this weekend, but you've got a very keen eye on one of them, Shannon Courtney versus Ebony Bridges. Firstly, you put this tweet out saying that you would happily fight the winner or the loser. How do you actually see that fight going? Because it's quite an interesting one, which is splitting people's opinion.
Yeah, it's a strange one. It's hard to really put a massive opinion on it because I've never really watched Ebony Bridges, only up until, you know, when there was a bit of Twitter spatting here and there and, you know, how as it goes. And I've seen little clips. I've never actually fully watched her fight. Obviously, Shannon, you know, she's done fantastic to have come back off that loss and then obviously get a good win. And it's one of those, I personally believe that Shannon will do it, I think. And this isn't being disrespectful to Ebony Bridges, but I'm sure I'll get, you know, jipped for saying it. But from the clips I've seen of her last fight, she doesn't seem very fast in her punches, quite slow combinations. So I think Courtney would catch her a lot quicker, but you know, who knows? And obviously everybody's raving about it. It's hard because it's strange that that's already a world title. But I know they say, you know, it's a difficult with women and how many are out there. And you know what? If I were given that opportunity, you're not going to say no, are you? So, you know, utmost respect. And obviously I'm backing the British girl because, you know, we need to back our own. And I do think, you know, I think she'll do the business.
Yeah, you mentioned that. I mean, a lot of people have said, you know, it's quite early for a world title fight. I guess the pool is smaller, obviously, in the female game. I had the same conversation with Rachel Ball not too long ago. But, you know, you've had an extensive amateur career. You know, you fought in the World Championships, the European Championships. You've won a Commonwealth gold, European Union gold. So is it a little bit frustrating to see those fights going ahead? And do you feel like you should be right up there in the mix as well with these ladies?
Yeah, it's tough. Obviously, you get a lot of Twitter trolls, as they call it, and they're saying, well, you've only had three pro fights. And I'm like, hang on a minute. I've got an extensive, and yes, it's in the amateur game, but I have boxed at the top level against top girls. And I don't feel like I need to go and build up fights by boxing journey women or journeymen, you know, as they would say it. So I'm just like, I just want to be given that opportunity. And hopefully, you know, I've got a great management team, S Jam Boxing, Sam and Adam. And obviously Sam's knocking on Eddie's door every day for me. But obviously, he's got a lot of boxes, and obviously with the backlog of COVID, and you can only have so many people on so many shows. So, you know, I believe they're interested. It's just I've got to await my time. So frustrating as it is, because I'm one of those people that once I'm on it, I want to be properly on it, and I want that date, and I want to push on. So I can't wait for Sam to ring me up and go, right, at least you've got a fight date. This is when it is. And then, you know, I'm training hard now. But it's a different type of training, isn't it, when you've got that focus and that goal ahead.
So to clarify, you're in a position now where you are literally waiting for the call. When it's there, boom, you could take a fight, possibly even at fairly short notice, but you're ready to go now.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, obviously, yeah, I'm training, but it'd be nice to be given, you know, I don't want to be like, was it Becky Connolly? Fair play to her. You know, one weekend was scaffolding, the next week. It's not something like that I'd want to do, because you want that preparation, you want that focus, don't you? But you never say never, do you? And if you get given that opportunity, then I'll have to go for it. I just want to be given the opportunity. But, you know, it's a strange one, because I do see a lot of girls now turning over quite quickly. And I know it's a difficult time, because amateurs is kind of gazumped a bit, hasn't it, with COVID, and then obviously the Olympic qualifiers, like the likes of Sandy Ryan, absolutely correct decision for Sandy to turn over, and she'll smash the pros. But then you've got other girls that were on GB, not really done massive things, and then have seen this, you know, the bright lights, and start and bang turned over. And I just think, you know, get that experience first, enjoy it, and enjoy the amateur side, because I don't think people realise how tough the pro side of it is unless you get that ultimate backing. Otherwise, it's, you know, it's ticket selling. You're not going to earn any money. You're going to have to work as well as obviously be a pro professional boxer, where some of the girls that are on GB, you're getting funded, you're getting housed, you're getting clothes, you're getting watered. You know, it's an amazing facility. So it's a tough decision, and I can understand why people are turning over, because they're seeing what's happening. But had I been younger and been on GB, I'd have stayed on GB and gone all that way to get, you know, look at the main world champions, like the male ones are all pretty much Olympians or Commonwealth champions. You can see that. I think with the female side, look at Katie Taylor, obviously Savannah Marshall, Chantel, she spent lots of time on GB. They're all world champions. I think you've only got the one that sticks out is Terry Harper, but I don't think there's many Terry Harpers about. She's very talented and stupidly, you know, she gives it her all, doesn't she? So
100%, yeah.
I don't think there's many of them out there.
Yeah, no, you raised some interesting points there. As I understand it, I believe Rachel Ball is in line to fight the winner of this fight of the weekend. That's how I understand it. But, you know, you'd be willing to jump in with, because I think it's going to be a good fight. I think it's going to be a competitive fight, actually. So you'd be willing to jump in with the person who isn't successful on the night, or even, you know, you're basically saying, just get me in there, aren't you, really?
Yeah. Do you know what? I don't want to say, oh, I'm not fighting her or I'm not doing this. Just get me in the mix. That's all I want, you know. I feel like, you know, just give me that opportunity. And like you've explained about, oh, I've got all that pedigree. It's not that I've just, you know, some of the girls, and they'll be coming out and they'll say, and they've won an ABA championships, you know, or elite championships. I want to make times. You know, and that were at different weights. So, and because people be like, oh, you're not a bantamweight, you was flyweight. Well, I started off boxing at featherweight and won European and world medals at featherweight. I then boxed at 54 kilos, which is like bantam, super bantam, won medals at that. And then I, only because it wasn't an Olympic weight, I had to drop down to 51. And the only reason really why we stayed at 51 to turn pro was to get that Nicola Adams fight. And unfortunately, she retired, didn't she? So.
Yeah, she didn't want that smoke, as they say. but yeah, I mean, you're from Chorley as well, aren't you? Now, Chorley's got a good boxing scene, really good boxing, from even back from like the Michael Jenningses, but even now, like Jack Catchell's coming through as well.
Jack, yeah.
And I've just heard some good news that Fitzy is back, someone that you used to train with, Scott Fitzgerald. which is great news because he's too talented, the guy, to not come back. And I know he's had his ups and downs problems.
He's had some tough times, hasn't he? And sounds like he's obviously back on it and focused. And I think as long as he's on it fully and gives it his all, he's someone not to be, he's not someone to be messed with, is he? Because look at them two wins he got. And, I hope for both Fowler and for Scott that rematch occurs, because, Fowler's held his hands up and said, you know what, I underestimated him. You know, it was such a close fight, wasn't it? But obviously he got that knockdown, Fitzy, and it was one of those. It could have gone either way, but that knockdown gave it to Scott. And I think it's always going to be something that'll chew at Fowler until he can try and get, his comeuppance.
Well, that's a good prospect to look forward to. Wish Fitzy the best. It's been really great speaking to you. We've got through this without any kids any interrupting us either end, which is great.
I can hear my little man shouting, but it's all the way downstairs, so I'm okay. He's being very vocal. I think he wants his bottle, that's why. So
right, well, I'll let you get back to him.
Yeah, I wish obviously both girls all the best. I don't know them personally, so obviously Ebony Bridget, it's all about Twitter, and we had our spats on Twitter, but of utmost respect to her as well. And like I say, I'll quite happily get in the ring with either one of them. I believe, and rightly so, Rachel Ball, getting COVID and going through what she's been through. And again, she's done amazing things, so I think she deserves a shot at that world title, doesn't she? Because that's who should have been fighting for it this weekend.
Yeah. And all the best to Rachel as well. Definitely. Well, let's fingers crossed. I'm sure Sam's working behind the scenes, as you say, knocking on Eddie's door. And
You just keep on at Sam for me as well.
yeah. I'll tag him in this and I will do.
No, he's brilliant, to be fair. He's absolutely great. So I appreciate his and Adam's support, especially through me saying, right, I'm going to have to give it a break. And they were absolutely fantastic, supporting me all the way. And then straight away, it was like, just let us know when you're ready. And I'm ringing them up and Sam's going, Lisa, calm down. You've only just had the baby. can't wait to get back at it.
Brilliant. Hopefully it won't be long to wait now. Lisa, thanks very much for your time. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
Yeah, you too. Take care. All right, thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.